Welcome to In the Hyperloop. My name is Blake. Today we're talking with Thor Myklebust, who's from one of Europe's largest research institutes called SENTEF. I saw an interesting article from them. It was titled, Salmon Delivered by Hyperloop. This article was a spin-off from a SENTEF report called Technological Trends That Affect the Transportation Industry for Norwegian National Transportation Plan. And this SENTEF report showed that it's unlikely that Hyperloop will be transporting people at first, but it's a great way in Norway to ship goods such as freshly killed salmon, where speed in transporting them to airports is very important. The authors of this report are from different scientific and technological fields, and they thought this use of the Hyperloop was probably the best for Norway. A Norwegian Hyperloop might be commercially available in 2025 for transporting goods, but they point out the Norwegian landscape, because of the mountains and the fjords, will present a challenge to large-scale development. The good news is that, in a sense, if estimates are correct, they could have a Norwegian test track of Hyperloop in 2020. So let's listen in to Thor to get a sense of how a business developer and researcher from SENTEF developed this Hyperloop report. Thanks, Thor, and welcome to In the Hyperloop. Thank you so much for joining today.
Thank you.
Thank you. So I mentioned in the introduction, you are with SENTEF and you are a business development with a specialty in software engineering, safety and security. Can you tell me a little bit more about SENTEF and, you know, how your role fits in their mission?
SENTEF is our research foundation. So all the income is going back to the company. Mm. So we have no investors involved. Mm-hmm. We are a research foundation that focus on research that are relevant for Norwegian industry. And safety has been focused on in the offshore industry, but now we also use it in or try to use it in other industries like the future Hyperloop and so on. And that may also be very important if you shall transport both people and fish in Norway.
Yeah, and that's actually how I kind of found your organization, through a great article about salmon delivery by Hyperloop and mail by drone. And so how did you become interested in these future technologies or working for SINTEF?
Well, that's one of the, let's say, missions for SINTEF. We shall start with new technology and do research. And we have... I have always been interested in new technology. We know about, let's say, whatever Elon Musk is doing. We try to follow him. And we, you know, Norway buy 10% of all the Teslas in the world. So we like to, we like a lot of the products he is making.
Yes. Yeah, it's amazing how there are just so many Teslas in Norway. And you're really at the forefront of electronic vehicles.
The reason is, of course, if you buy a diesel car, you have to pay twice as much as in other countries. But if you buy an electrical car, you pay the same price as in other countries. So that's one of the main answers to the result.
Well, Thor, in your role as a business development person, what are some of the biggest business challenges that you face?
That's get the funding and get partners early on. When it comes to Hyperloop, we have established a good network already, but we still have to get funding, and we still have to have some ideas to develop parts of the Hyperloop. Mm-hmm. But we are now in discussion with some companies, and we are also have good communications within Scandinavia, and we later this year, we will arrange a seminar where we invite the industry from Norway and also from Sweden and Finland.
Oh, wow. Yeah, there's been a huge interest in connecting, you know, Helsinki to Stockholm with a crazy Hyperloop. And so I think this is a great time for Norway to kind of hold a conference to bring these different parties together.
Yes, and we do cooperate with those persons. So FS Links is part of the seminar. They take part in it. And we also have a lot of discussions with them so we can, let's say, move together, and because it's a lot of challenges, so we have to work together to achieve our goals.
Yeah, exactly. So we've hit on some of the challenges that you face, you know, putting a seminar together, you know, working with other companies on new technology. What do you like working about in this research community or in your role in particular?
The most positive part with starting with Hyperloop is that more or less everyone is positive and think this is a funny project.
Yeah.
So I've also started other projects, and then you always meet some negative people. This is not possible. This is not relevant or so. But when it comes to Hyperloop, for one or another reason, everyone is so excited about it.
That's really interesting. I would agree with you. It's whether it's with students that are working on pods or, you know, actual companies that are building and trying to, you know, build the Hyperloop. But everybody seems very positive about this. A very can-do spirit.
Yes.
Yeah.
And a lot of people have already asked to become a test pilot. So
wow, they're very brave in Norway. You know, looking into the future, do you see Hyperloop perhaps replacing vehicle trips or used as kind of a weekend getaway?
Well, in Norway, the first part is to remove trucks from the roads. So we hope that we can, for example, transport fish, you know. And flight companies transport more fish to Asia than people. So we sell a lot of salmon, and we plan to increase the production of salmon with several hundred percent. So that is a problem. We do not have roads to take care of all the trucks. So we should maybe do it by using Hyperloop, but also, of course, boats, when you can have, let's say, slow delivery of the fish.
It's those massive fish farms. That requires a lot of transportation back and forth.
Yeah.
So let's switch gears a little bit. What two cities would you love to see connected with a Hyperloop or some type of fast transportation?
Well, of course, I would like to have between Trondheim and Oslo, but I think we should start with, let's say, shorter route or shorter tube first. So that's why we are looking at the fish part.
That would be a really convenient trip to Oslo, though.
It would be. You know, the market wish to have, if you fish salmon or take the salmon, and they wish to have it only one day after we have bring it up from the sea, so it takes only 24 hours. So then you should use flight and Hyperloop, maybe.
Yeah. Wow, that's incredibly fresh. Well, that, you know, that would be great. Also, you know, if you could ask Elon Musk any question, Hyperloop related or not, what might you ask?
I would like him, not ask him, but challenge him to pay support our Hyperloop project with $500 for each Tesla sold in Norway.
Awesome. Yes, that would be a great way to finance the start
that's
of this.
That's a good starting point. The other question is, we would be very happy if you could join us for a Hyperloop seminar for the Norwegian and Scandinavian industry 11th of September in Oslo.
That would be amazing.
We will even pay the travel cost.
Well, sold. I will make sure he gets aware of this.
That's great. Thank you.
That's brilliant. Hopefully he will watch this and hear this. So,
I hope so.
Yeah. Well, Thor, thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to join me within the Hyperloop. For our viewers that want to learn more about SINTEF, you know, where would be the best place to go?
The best place is to go our internet page, which is SINTEF.no and then /Hyperloop.
Perfect. That's very helpful. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.